Like, I'm serious.
Oh my God, I'm serious.
Bitch, what you say?
You don't know what?
Because I got your bitch. I got your bitch.
Your bitch.
I got your bitch. You know what?
That's my family.
Oh, Lord. I don't know what's going on, baby.
All right, you guys. What's up, party people? I am back. I'm so sorry, but for those of you that are still here, thank you, thank you, thank you. I had some serious things going on with family and my mom, but I am back, ready to go. And we're going to make a quick recap review of season 5, episode 20, Shimmer Down of A Life After Lockup. All right, party people. Let's do it. All right, you guys, I'm going to make this quick because I'm basically obviously behind on the season. So let's start it off with where we were before. Let's start off with Shavel and Quaylon. Okay, basically, this is Shavel's. This is her bridal shower. As we know, this season it's all been a battle of the mothers between her mom and his mom. Although I'm kind of not understanding it. His mother was really nice in this episode and offered to not come if her mother was going to act crazy. Now, I think her mother is certainly justified given the history of their relationship and not liking him. But if you're not paying any money, then I don't know where she's getting this sort of entitlement. I feel like Shavel needs to kind of check her and do kind of like Quaylon suggested, like maybe just tell her the truth, like, yeah, you keep doing this, you're not going to be there. So we'll see. In a nutshell, Shavel is frustrated with her mother, and her mother basically kind of snaps off. She's given that very much, she's giving the very much, who's going to check me, boo? That's what she's really giving. So that's kind of where she's coming up with. So at this point, I feel like they have to make a decision. Do you want her at the wedding or not? And if you do, then you got to be ready. Like her mother said to her, like, you act like you don't know me. Yeah, you should know by now that she's gonna act a fool. So it is what it is. So let's move on to our next couple. All right. Okay, so let's go on to Brittany and Key Rock. They have gone up to New York to visit Brittany's family, although which is at this point just her grandmother, because her mother actually does not approve of their relationship. Now, it's really interesting because I think Brittany, Key Rock is sort of beating around the bush, kind of doesn't want to say, oh, I think your mother might be racist. But I think that's sort of like the elephant in the room, so to speak. So they go to see, and it actually turns out really well. I have a picture of it here. Hold on. Let me go to... this is actually Blaine and Lindsey. So I'll get back to them in a minute, but here we go. So Key Rock brings Brittany's grandmother flowers. That's what's kind of going on here. And it's so like her grandmother is so lovely. Key Rock really makes an effort to speak Spanish and it's all very nice and sweet. Her uncle comes. Her uncle is also supportive of their relationship and they take photos. But so far, no appearance of her actual mother and father. So it's left to be determined. You know, maybe that'll kind of be, maybe they'll come around at the end or they'll pop up at the wedding. But so far, it's just all about grandma. Now, the grandmother did make the suggestion about them moving up there because Key Rock is doing air conditioning HVAC type work. And she's like, oh, you should come up here. They get paid a lot. And Brittany seems to really think that's pretty cool. But Key Rock is kind of like, you know, I got a brother at home on crack, basically. So he doesn't, he's not as excited. I think he wants to stay. And I believe they're in Virginia, right? So that's pretty much all that happens with them. Moving right along. Let's go back to Lindsey and Blaine. Let's see. Do I have their overlay? Here we go. So basically, they've been fighting. There's nothing really too much great going on with them. Honestly, I felt like this episode was sort of a snoozer. On a scale of 1 to 10, I would give it like a 5, really a 4, honestly. Really, the Quaylon Shavel thing was like the most interesting thing that happened. But basically, between Lindsey and Blaine, they've been fighting, they've been arguing, and even though they have a knockdown drag out, Lindsey still goes to try on wedding gowns with her sister and her mother, who are there because they love her but don't think it's a good idea. And so they both tell her, okay, you know, Blaine has been complaining about you to us, and it's so crazy. And she totally flips out because he's complaining about her to her daughter, which is totally inappropriate for sure. But basically, he's saying that she's a bully, which she is. She's like, you don't make no money, you don't do nothing. And every other day she's trying to kick him out the house. So she is bully. He ain't lying on her, and he's not really keeping it a secret. And you're arguing in front of the kids already as it is. So I think she's basically just looking for an excuse. I think she kind of wants somebody who's going to right her if she actually gets jail time, but she don't really want to be in a relationship. So, you know, maybe she's looking for conjugal visits. I'm not really sure, but I think she's looking for a way out, because to me, complaining that she bullies him when she does indeed sort of bully him is a lot to say, okay, we're going to end the relationship, instead of just being like, dude, don't talk to my family. That could be an easy fix. So nothing too exciting or very interesting happening here with them. Let's see. All right. The next couple we're going to check out, let's check out Shawn and Sara. I have a picture of them as well. Here they are right here. And he's basically trying to convince her to buy a new tow truck because the one that he bought already is raggedy. And he's afraid to tell her the truth that he hasn't been sending any money to his kids because this truck is basically a piece of crap. And I don't, so this, the only thing I can say about this whole storyline right here is this right here. Fake, fake, and more fake. Like, I don't even know why you guys are on the show. Maybe we need to bring back Brittany and Marcelino. But yeah, this whole storyline, she spent $25,000 to get a tummy tuck and a boob job, and he spent $25,000 on a raggedy truck, and now they both can certainly agree that they broke. So I don't know why he's afraid to tell her that the truck needs repairs. That's crazy. And of course, his baby mama is like, I don't care about the truck. The kids need like food and clothing. So you need to send me some money. So I don't know. I think they're okay as a couple. Their storyline is just, I don't know. It's just not, I don't know. To me, I think their storyline is just, it's not very interesting right here. So that's pretty much all that really happened with them. Nothing too groundbreaking. Let's see. Next up, let's talk about, oh, Jonomi and Red. Okay, so Red is back in St. Louis visiting his family. And so we meet right here. Little D is Red's friend. He met Jonomi like on Facebook and basically was like, yeah, man, come on, you can get over on her. And, you know, it honestly seemed like an online pimp situation. Let me know what you guys think. But totally crazy to me. Like, girl, who are you talking to on Facebook like this? And like, how are you letting them halfway online pass you around? I'm so confused. Jonomi, you seem like a very sweet girl. You know, you need to raise your standards and your self-esteem. But she seems to be trying to get it together. Like, she seems to be trying to put her foot down with Red. So when Red first gets to St. Louis, he's kicking it with his friends. He's trying to kind of dog her a little bit. What I did like is that her, what I did like was one of his friends. Oh yeah. The girl right there, his friend's wife, she took up for Jonomi. She was like, well, nah, it ain't cool if you, you know, looking at naked pictures of other girls. It's not cool if you are, it's not cool if you're looking at pictures of other girls. It's not no, when we in a relationship, it's not no single, it's we. So I like that even though her man was on Red's side, she stuck up for Joy. So I thought she was really a cool character. He basically feels, you know, he basically, I guess, starts to miss her a little bit. So I don't know what happened to the white girl he messed with the last time. Maybe she in a relationship now or something, which I have heard, I think. Shout out to Amber. I think that the girl that he slept with is pregnant. So maybe she had a boyfriend the whole time anyway. So, you know, maybe she's on to bigger and better things. So he decides he misses Joy. He goes home. And she's like, okay, you know, you didn't take my calls. She does have that close-knit cousins and sisters and stuff. So they're always like, girl, you know, he ain't nothing in a nice way, but we love you, boo. So basically she kind of traps him with that. Well, just tell me the truth. Honesty is the best thing. And so this fool, although it was going to come out because eventually she was going to watch the show, but this fool does, you know, we kind of left with the cliffhanger where he finally admits that when they fell out before, he did have sex with another girl. So I think at this point we do know, I think the last time I saw them on IG, they weren't together. So, you know, I don't know if the sex thing is enough to break them up or if there's more, but I think that's probably going to be it. She's probably going to be done and she can give him his $30 ring back. So, you know, no love lost there. So let's move on to who do we have here? Let's go back to Justine and Mike. So let's move on to Justine and Mike. Okay. So as we found out, Mike kind of fumbled the bag when it came to his parole. He's not able to move to Vegas. I do not understand how they make their money. Because she quit her job. Is he still selling gym shoes? He hasn't quite dropped any records. So I'm so confused on to where his money comes from. I'm still kind of concerned. But that being said, he has to pay $4,000, I think, a month for the mortgage in Las Vegas. And then now he still has to pay rent where he is, which I think they're being charged more because they're going to be there an extra few months. So his mom calls and says that she wants to bring the kids down to kind of stay with them for the summer and help Justine with the baby. So Justine actually goes for it, although she knows that his mom, even though they're laughing and smiling and kikiing in each other's face, she does know that his mom is still going to slip her that paternity test. And that's absolutely true. But here she is with the two little ones, Mason, and I believe the little girl's name is Nova. And I guess she's trying to teach them how to hold a baby. And so then we find out, let's move on to the next pic. Here's a picture of him and his oldest daughter, Melody. So we find out Melody basically is like, well, I want to go with you to Vegas. And this whole conversation, maybe it was edited or something, but I was so confused because basically he was kind of like, no, because you basically are the one taking care of Mason, his youngest son. Like, ever since he's been born, she stepped up to the plate. Now, I'm not really sure what Mason mama is doing, why Melody has to do all the work, but he does mention that. And then Melody is kind of like, well, I think my mom would, you know, her mother would be cool with her moving to Vegas. So he seems to say no at first, and then he seems to kind of back down off of it at the end and seems to imply that kind of once, you know, he gets back in Justine's good graces, he'll mention Melody coming out to Vegas with them. So we'll see what happens. But in upcoming news between these two, Justine did just give birth to their little girl, whom they named Manhattan Barbie. Make it make sense. I think Manhattan actually is a good, cute name. Barbie, maybe, I don't know, did the kids name her? Like, I'm confused by the Barbie part. But Manhattan, I think, is, you know, kind of cute and different. You know, Brooklyn is also a cute name. So I like the, you know, the New York borough names. But yeah, Barbie, I don't know. As a Black person, I can't deal with a person of color being named Barbie. But that's just me. I got to open my mind. I got to be more open. So let's see, moving right along. Actually, I think, do we have any more pics here? I think that's everybody. Shawn, Joy, Quaylon. I think that's it, folks. I think that's all. So thank you guys so much. I am back in it to win it. I'm going to be doing several different shows, some drama shows. So like, comment, subscribe. And I'm going to be doing the episode, tonight's episode of Life After Lockup. You know, probably by tomorrow. Or by Sunday for sure. So have a great weekend, you guys. Ciao for now, folks. I'm out of here. Bye.